He stands larger than life in the third floor lobby of the Owings Mills Library, an icon of the Negro Baseball Leagues.
He was a man that was known to be one of the greatest pitchers that ever played the game.
Leon Day was born in 1916 and raised in Baltimore. He dropped out of Douglas High School because they didn't have a baseball team and started playing in sandlots.
So he was discovered in the sandlots of Baltimore by H. Rapp Dixon. And from that, he went on to a wonderful career in baseball.
Starting at just 17, Day played for multiple teams over his 22-year career, including the Baltimore Black Sox and the Baltimore Elite Giants. He played every position except catcher, but is most known as a pitcher.
He could run the bases, he could hit well, just everything that you would ask for in a modern day player. And really, if the times were differently, he should have been in the major leagues. He really should have.
That's why friend and historian Dr. Bob Hieronymus spent years petitioning the Baseball Hall of Fame in Cooperstown on behalf of Day, who was initially reluctant to pursue the honor.
He had no ego. He did not think he was the greatest player. He would point to everybody else and say, look at this guy's record, look at that guy's record.
But finally, in 1995, he became the only player from the Negro Leagues in Baltimore to be admitted to the Hall of Fame. He was 78 years old and sick in the hospital when he got the call.
He got very emotional, he teared up. He said, I got to get out of here, get up there, meeting Cooperstown to receive his award. He died 6 days later.
His widow, Geraldine Day, accepted the award on his behalf. She, along with some neighbors, started the Leon Day Foundation, which connects kids in Baltimore with sports. President Michelle Freeman says Day's legacy is an important one.
I think it means for a boy or a girl in Baltimore that they too can go to the Hall of Fame. They too can have a dream that he had, and I think that's what we try to do with the foundation.
Leon Day Park, complete with baseball fields, sits quietly in West Baltimore, another nod to his accomplishments. It's the type of tribute that fits a humble man, whose name is now forever written in history as one of baseball's greatest players.
Here at the library in Owings Mills, you can find a wealth of information on the Negro Leagues, as folks work to give more players from Baltimore the recognition they deserve. In Owings Mills, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.